Hi, this is Tim. Recently I've gotten a number of emails from people asking me how I did my projection or video mapping. And so they wanted to know what steps I took. And so in this video I'm going to briefly go over what I did. There's a number of ways you can do it, different techniques. If you're doing a projection mapping on a large building, what I do here probably wouldn't work as well. In that case, they usually use a camera. They take a picture where their projector will be sitting at the same aspect ratio, same focal point and everything. And then they use that photo that they've taken to add animation to it and different, you know, colors, to change things up on it. What I'm doing though instead is I've got my objects, which in the last video, the projection mapping video, you saw I had a couple boxes. So I've got my objects, I've got a projector, and then the computer. So I'm going to use the projector and project onto here, onto the objects, and I'm just going to create my different colors using that. I'm not going to take a photo and then work on the photo. So it's easy to do on something small like this. It wouldn't probably work on something larger. So let's get started. I'll go step by step and show you what I'm using. I am using Microsoft Paint, Adobe Photoshop. And then I'll put all the pictures or the photos that I take, or the different images with the different colors, I'll put that together into a movie using the Sony Movie Studio software. So let's get started then. Okay, so I've got my projector on. And you can see that it's just projecting the screen from my laptop up on the wall and on the objects that I want to do the projection mapping on. So I'm going to open up Paint, and what we're going to do is we're going to choose the lines, and we're just basically going to trace the boxes using the lines, and make sure you don't have too thick of a line. So I chose the thin line, I've got black, and you probably could use any other color you wanted. So what we're going to do, if you can see up on the boxes there, is basically on all the edges, we're going to make an outline. Right on the corners there are the edges. Just like that. And going to, right from that corner there, down over to this, and you want to make sure they're all connected, because these will be, you'll be filling in these different squares or different sections that you're making. So let's go down here, go up, and I can see that I'm not on the right on the edge, so I'm going to change that, or I'm going to undo that one, because we want it pretty much right on the edge there. Okay, so you can see on my computer I've got the boxes outlined, what I'm going to use. So now I want to save this, and then we're going to use some other software to do the rest of what we're doing. Okay, so what I've done is I've opened up Adobe Photoshop, and of course you can use whatever software you're comfortable with. And I've got the image that I saved from Microsoft Paint. I open that up, and I put a black background. That just makes it, when you're projecting later and making your movie, you don't have a lot of white behind it. It gives a lot of contrast. And so what you'll want to do also is make sure that you're lined up, your projector is lined up, and your image is lined up on the objects up that you're going to be projecting on. And now what you're essentially going to do is start filling in different colors. Now what I do is I sometimes I'll use colors and I'll fill one in. Maybe I'll do two like that, and then I'll save it. And with this, I can make save a copy or save as. So let's see. We're just going to save it. And there we go. And then what you can do is undo it, or you can just change colors. You can also go up here and you can choose different patterns and fill that in, maybe save it, and you'll probably make a whole bunch of these. However long your video will be for your projection mapping, but you can just save as many different images as you want, and then later you'll combine them all into a video that you've made. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make a whole bunch of these, save them, and then I'll show you how I combine it later into make a video. Okay, so after putting all those pictures together into a movie, you save it and then you play it back and you make sure that the projector is lined up on your images or your boxes or whatever your subject is that you're projection mapping on. And so you play it back and you record that, and that basically is your projection mapping. Again, this is a really simple, I did it very simple steps. My lines aren't always exact, and then you can add music also if you'd like. So there you have it. Hope that helps some of you who had some questions. And again, this is really, I did it very quickly. I didn't really do many patterns. I just added different things randomly. You can do it however you'd like and add animation and different sounds.